How's it going, everyone? I hope you've been having a good day today. I know I'm fairly late to the party for this game, but screw it. I finally downloaded Punishing Grey Raven earlier this month to give the game a try. I wouldn't consider myself a hardcore gacha game player, however, that didn't stop me from hearing all the hype around this game, so I had to give it a try and see what the hype was about. I haven't had much experience in hack and slash gacha games, outside games like Genshin Impact, that of which I played on the PC. That game just runs like shit on my phone, but fortunately, I'll be playing Punishing Grey Raven on a very powerful tablet. I'm not going to talk too much about the game itself, because there are definitely other videos out there that cover the topic fantastically well, but I did want to share my initial thoughts and feelings toward the title. I'll start off on a positive note and say I was definitely infatuated with the fast-paced and beautifully crafted animations of all the characters and their attacks. Granted, I was playing this on a very capable tablet with all visual settings maxed with everything running buttery smooth. In terms of the characters' aesthetic and combat designs, the way they moved, and the style in which they attacked, I had no complaints. The only thing I didn't really care for was the dark and desolate looking UI, although that's more of a personal preference. I understand it has to fit the theme of the game, which takes place in an apocalyptic world, and therefore needs to project a serious and sometimes darker tone. I'm simply more used to games with a brighter and vibrant user interface that have jazzy or catchy music playing for every part of the menu. With all those minute things aside, what obviously stands out in this game is the fast-paced combat, which to me felt pretty repetitive and exhausting when I first started. Granted, all I did was simply use one character and just spam the attack button like a brainless monkey. It wasn't until later when I formed a team and learned about different team synergies and paradigm shifts that added an entire new layer of depth to the combat, which can be entertaining for a short period of time, but it's not something I would want to do for hours on end. In summary, given the relatively short time of me playing this, I can assuredly say Punishing Grey Raven is a solid gacha game, and like most other gacha games, will end up being a side game once you start to complete most of the story, and then your time afterwards would mainly be spent logging in and doing your dailies. This works out for me personally because I don't see myself wanting to tap my fingers to death for hours at a time. The game provides quick bursts of fast-paced entertainment that you can pick up at any time. The gacha rates are averagely fair, not the greatest, but not the worst. The cast is diverse enough that you'll find someone you really like, with everyone having a very unique playstyle. There's not a golden tier list simply because each character has their own personal use, and everyone is arguably viable, which I like. It takes away the worry about having to fix it yourself to a tier list. There are enough events and side activities to keep you occupied. But other than that, Punishing Grey Raven is just another standard gacha game at its core. If you're any fan of gacha games and waifus, you'll feel right at home here. That pretty much wraps up my initial thoughts on Punishing Grey Raven. At its core, it acts like most other gacha games, aside from a few unique aspects that sets it apart, which is more effort than what most other gacha games will put in. If you'd like to see more Punishing Grey Raven content from me, or just want to share your thoughts on the game, then let me know in the comments below. I'm sure most people will share the same opinion, but I definitely welcome different ideas and perspectives. Thanks again for watching, everyone, and I'll see you in the next one. Beautiful, beautiful.